Good day to all of you. In today's lesson, we will learn new things, but before that, we will revise our previous classes. Can you tell what is the menu bar? Menu bar is the most important part of writer. It is from here that we can do all our work related to the files, like formatting text, merging documents or saving files, etc. The menu bar contains all these options. It has the options for file, edit, view, insert, format, table, tools window, and help. Also, in each of these options, we have submenus which help us in making or modifying any document. What is a standard toolbar? Standard toolbar is a shortcut method by which a user, as per his requirements, can make it himself in the menu bar by choosing what is needed from the available submenus and then can use those options directly from there. What is formatting toolbar? Let us first learn what is formatting. On any selected paragraph or line, any changes that you make, like changing the style of writing a word or changing its size, changing the color of a word, underlining a word or a line, or highlighting a word by making it bold, all these kinds of changes being made on a line or on any paragraph are collectively called formatting. Go ahead and power on your computers. Now you will learn how to open the OpenOffice Writer files. Now let us watch this video and see how, using the stepwise method, we can open the Writer file. First of all, take your pointer to the Start button, which is on the lower left corner of your screen. With the mouse or the touchpad, left click on this Start button and a box will open. Select the All Programs option and click on that using the left button of the mouse or the touchpad. Look for OpenOffice in the window that opens and click there with the left button. Finally, find the OpenOffice Writer option and left click on that. Your OpenOffice Writer file will open by doing this. Have all of you been able to open the Writer file? If you are facing a problem, watch the video again and learn. Let us now begin today's class. In this lesson, you will all learn about ruler, status bar, drawing bar, and text boundaries. Then we will type a paragraph. And then in the end, we will learn about using some of the options of the formatting bar, like font name, font size, bold, italics, underline, etc. Look at the picture in front of you and tell what is it called. This is called a ruler. Do you know what do we use a ruler for? Well, we use the ruler to set up our page. The ruler helps us in setting up the margin on the page from where we would like to start typing our lines or paragraphs. There are two types of rulers, horizontal and vertical. And as you can see, the ruler is like a scale. The picture being shown to you is of the status bar. Do you know what is status bar? The status bar tells you about the status of your writer text, like how many pages are there in the file that you are working on. It also tells you about the page number that you are currently working on. The status bar also has the zoom box. We will now learn about the drawing bar and get to know what is the drawing bar. Drawing bar is just below the status bar and it contains many drawing shapes. These shapes, the shapes available are circle, rectangle, different types of stars, and the font work gallery, etc. All these shapes are used for many types of work depending on our needs. What are text boundaries? Text boundary helps us to be able to type text within the given boundary. On our page, a box appears which has boundaries on all four sides. Look at the text in front of you and type it out on the page on your computer. Then we will learn how to format paragraphs. All of you start typing this paragraph. Do you know what we need to do before formatting any text or paragraph or line? Let us learn what we need to do before formatting a paragraph. In order to format a line or paragraph, you first necessarily need to select it. You can select your chosen line or paragraph in three different ways. Do you know what these methods are? If we need to select the whole line or the whole page where we have typed, we will press Ctrl plus A button together. This will select the whole line or paragraph. When the line or paragraph gets selected, then the text that we have typed gets displayed in a blue color background, which indicates that our text has been selected. With the help of this video, let us now learn how we can use the shortcut command to select a line, text or paragraph. You can see that a cursor is blinking at the end of the text that we want to select. Now, to use the shortcut command to select the line, text or paragraph, we use Ctrl plus A. So, with your left hand, keep the Ctrl button pressed and then press A. And as is being shown in the video, your text or line or paragraph gets selected and it gets a blue color in the background. If you want to unselect the text or paragraph or line, you just have to go in the area which has been selected and press with your left button on the mouse or the touchpad, and your text gets unselected. The second method is one where we use our mouse or touchpad to select the text. In this method, we need to bring our cursor to either the beginning or the end of the word or line or paragraph that we want to select. Now, if you're using a touchpad, press the left button with one hand and with the other hand, swipe a finger towards the right or left such that the text you want to select begins to appear in a blue background. With the mouse, with practice, you can easily do it with one hand by pressing the left button with the finger and dragging the mouse to select the text with the same hand. With the help of this video, we will learn how to select our line, text or paragraph with the help of the mouse or touchpad. Look at the video. Remember that it's important to note where your cursor is. Like right now, the cursor is at the end of your paragraph. So you have to hold the left button of your mouse or touchpad down with your left hand and then drag towards the left side of your with your other hand and then drag upwards. So this way you will see that the blue color gets in the background and your whole text or paragraph or line gets selected. If you want to unselect this text or paragraph or line, you just have to take your cursor inside the blue area and click with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad once and it gets unselected. The third method is that we can use our keyboard to select a line or paragraph. To do this, we use the shift button and the arrow keys to select our line or text. As you already know, the keyboard has four arrow keys. Left arrow, right, up and down arrow keys. You all have also learned how to use these arrow keys. So, let us now learn by watching the video how can we select our desired text with the use of shift button and the arrow keys. With the help of this video, we will learn how we can use the shift button and the arrow keys to select our line, text or paragraph. To do so, we must be careful about where the cursor is, whether it is at the beginning of the line or at the end of the line. Like in this case in the video, you see that the cursor is at the end of our paragraph. So now to select with the left hand, we keep the shift button pressed down and with the right hand we can use the left arrow key to go leftwards, and when we keep on clicking on the left arrow key, our text on the left side of the cursor keeps getting selected as is being shown in the video. So this way we can select the whole text. You also know that there are four arrow keys and you have already learned how these arrow keys can be used to go towards the left, right, up or down. If you want to unselect this text or paragraph or line, you just have to take your cursor inside the blue area and click with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad once and it gets unselected. Remember, if you want to select the entire text or the full page, you can use the shortcut command which is Ctrl plus A. So to do that, you will keep the Ctrl key pressed with your left hand and then with the right hand you will press the A button to select the entire text or your page. Now, all of you select the first line using one of the methods you have just learned. We will now begin to learn how we format the text. Before you begin formatting, make sure that you have selected the text that you want to format. You will know that the text has been selected if it appears in blue background. If you want to select the whole line or whole page in one keystroke, then you need to press the control key with your left hand and press A with your right hand. You will see that the whole line or page gets selected. We will first change the style of our line. To make this change, you need to get to the font name option. Once you are there, you will see a drop-down box next to this option. Click on this box and a box will open which will contain many different writing fonts. So, let us now learn by watching the video. Let us watch this video to learn how we can change the style of writing or the font of our writing. To do so, as is being shown in the video, you have to first select the text. And to select all of the text, you can use your left hand to press the control button and press A, the key A, with your right hand, and the text gets selected. Now, as is being shown in the video, you have to take your cursor or pointer to this arrow here, which is called font name, and left click on it. Once you left click on this, a number of names appear. These are all different styles of writing, and you can select the style of writing which you like. If you want to see more styles which are above, you can use the up arrow key here. Or if you want to go down, you can use the down arrow key. Or if you press on this with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad, then you can drag it up or down and select the font that you like. If you face any problem in changing the font, you can ask your teachers for help. Remember that if your text is not selected, the font will not change. Now, you will learn about the font size with which you can increase or decrease the size of the text. Let us watch the video which will tell us how we can increase the size of alphabets in a line or a paragraph. With the help of this video, let us now see how we can increase or decrease the font size or the size of the writing. Firstly, you need to select the line or the text or the paragraph. And if you want to select the whole paragraph, you can use the shortcut command Ctrl plus A. After this, in the format bar, look for the font size option, and if you click on that arrow there, as is shown in the video, you see a number of sizes being shown in the drop-down box. These are different sizes of writing, and when you go and click with your mouse or buttons, mouse or touchpad's left button, you will see that your writing size or the font size also changes. So you can use the font size to decrease or increase the size of the writing or the font size. With the option shown in front of us, we will now learn how to make the text bold, or in other words, make your writing thicker and darker. Let us learn this with the help of a video. In order to make the text bold, which means thicker and blacker, we will use the format commands. So first we need to select the text that we need to bold. So we will use the shortcut command Ctrl plus A to select the entire text of this paragraph as is being shown in the video. Then in the format bar, go to the place where B is written and using your mouse or touchpad, press with the left button and you will notice that your text becomes bold or thicker and darker. You can also do this by using the shortcut command for this, which is Control plus B. Now, if you want to remove the bold, you have to go back to the B once again and use the mouse or the touchpad and press the left button. You can also remove the bold by using the shortcut command once again, which is Control plus B. Next, we will learn how to write text in italics. Italics is also a part of formatting. By using the italics option, you can make the selected text tilted or you can write with tilted letters. If you want to use the shortcut method to italicize your text, you need to use Control plus I. Let us learn this with the help of a video. Using the method taught to you, select your line or paragraph. So we will use the shortcut command Control plus A to select the entire text of this paragraph as is being shown in the video. And then when you go and click on the I button in the formatting bar, your text will be italicized. Or it will become tilted. If you want to use the shortcut method to italicize your text, you need to use Control plus I. If you want to change the text back to normal from italics, then you can again use the I button in the formatting bar or use the shortcut command. Now we will learn how to underline text. Underline means that you draw a line below the text that you want to highlight. You can do the underlining after you have typed the text or even before you type the text. Let us learn this with the help of a video. Using the method taught to you, select your line or paragraph. Like all other formatting options, even when we want to underline some text, we first need to select the text. To do so, as is being shown in the video, you have to first select the text. And to select all of the text, you can use your left hand to press the Control button and press A, the key A, with your right hand, and the text gets selected. Then we just need to go to the U button in the formatting option. When you click on this button, you will see the text you selected has got underlined, or you will see a line below your selected text. If you want to use the shortcut method, you need to use Control plus U. If you want to remove the underlining, you can go again to the underline icon and click on it while your text is still selected. Note that you can use all these three options, bold, italics, and underline, after selecting the text. And if you use these options before typing out the text, then the text will appear in the formatting that you opt for. We will end today's class here. So all of you should close your writer file. And if you still face a problem with closing the file, do watch the video again carefully and learn. In order to close the writer file, you will use the same method as you have learned for closing the paint file. So take your pointer or the cursor to the top right corner where there is a cross sign and click on that with the mouse or the touchpad using the left button. You see three options appearing in a window. Since you do not want to save right now, you can say discard, which is the middle option. Click on that with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad, and your file, writer file, gets closed. After that, please shut down the computer properly. And if you have any doubts about shutdown method, you must watch the video again. Let us now learn how to shut down your computer. Bring your pointer to the start button as is being shown in the video. Next, use your mouse or touchpad to click on the left button. A box appears and you have to look for the shutdown option and take your pointer there. Then, using your mouse or touchpad, click with the left button and this will make your computer shut down. In today's lesson, you all have learned status bar, drawing bar, and the text boundaries. Then you typed a paragraph. And towards the end of this class, you also learned about using some of the options of the formatting bar, like font name, font size, bold, italics, and underline. Thank you.